Hi, very good morning, you all. I'm Lakshmi Narayana Gunta, PGT in Zoology at APMS Junior College Karavanja. I'm also working as NEET Super 60 Zoology faculty at Duppalavalsa, Srikakulam. Today, we are going to discuss the respiratory system of Periplaneta americana. As you know, the blood of cockroach doesn't have any respiratory pigments. As it lacks respiratory pigment, the blood of cockroach is colorless. As the respiratory pigment is absent, the cockroach blood, it cannot transport the oxygen to different parts of the body. In order to supply oxygen to different parts of the body, it has developed a specialized system called as the tracheal system, which carries oxygen directly to the okay. The respiratory system of cockroach consists of spiracles or the stigmata, trachea and the tracheoles. The stigmata are the spiracles, the trachea and the tracheoles. Let us discuss all these things one by one. Let us first discuss the spiracles. These spiracles or stigmata, they are 10 pairs in a cockroach, and these spiracles, they are the openings in the pleura. And there are two pairs in the thoracic region. They are thoracic spiracles, and 8 pairs in the abdominal region. They are abdominal spiracles. Whereas the 8 abdominal spiracles, they are present in the first 8 abdominal segments. Okay. The last 2 abdominal segments, they won't bear any spiracles. As the cockroach has more than 3 pairs of spiracles, the respiratory system of cockroach is called as polyneostic type of respiratory system. Poly means many, and as all the spiracles, they are functional. That's why it is also called as holoneostic. Holo means total. Total spiracles, they are functional. That's why it is also called as holoneostic type of respiratory system. And all the spiracles, they are valvular, means they are supplied with valves. Okay, the opening and closing of these spiracles is guarded by the valves. Okay, this is the opening of the spiracle present in the pleura, and this one is called as the stigmata of the spiracle, and this spiracle is guarded by a ring-like structure called as peritrine. Here you can observe the peritrine. This one is, and this one is the peritrine, and each spiracle, it leads into a small chamber called as the atrium. It is the atrium, and this spiracle opens into this chamber called as atrium. From here, a number of branches arise. The chamber is called as the atrium. The horizontal tracheae from the thoracic atrium, they join to form dorsal and ventral cephalic trunks. They supply blood to the head region of the cockroach. Okay, we have seen the thoracic atrium. Whereas coming to the abdominal atrium, from each abdominal atrium, 3 tracheal tubes arise, one on lateral side, one on dorsal side, one on ventral side. These lateral tracheal tubes of one side, they all unite to form a lateral longitudinal trunk. Similarly, the ventral abdominal atria of one side, they form into a ventral longitudinal tracheal trunk. And similarly, on the dorsal side, there are 2 dorsal longitudinal trunks. Okay. And the 3 pairs of longitudinal tracheal trunks, they are interconnected by commiseral tracheae. Here you can observe the commiseral tracheae. These are commiseral tracheae. And out of these, the lateral longitudinal tracheal trunks, they are the longest one. They are the longest ones. And the branches given off from these longitudinal tracheal trunks, they enter different organs and supply oxygen to those organs. And each tracheal branch ends in a tracheal cell or tracheoblast. This one is called as a tracheal cell or a tracheoblast. Okay. And the wall of this trachea, it consists of 3 layers. The outer layer is called as the basement membrane, the middle layer is called as the epithelium, and the innermost layer is called as the intima. This one is the epithelium, and The spiral thickenings present in the intima, these are called as the tinnidia. These tinnidia, they prevent the collapse of trachea. As we have C-shaped cartilaginous rings in our trachea, these C-shaped cartilaginous rings, they prevent the trachea from collapsing. Similarly, these tinnidia in cockroaches, they prevent the trachea from collapsing. Okay. And coming to the tracheoles. These tracheoles, they are the extensions of the tracheoblast cells. They are the tubular extensions of the tracheoblast cells. This one is the tracheoblast cell, and from these tracheoblast cells, the extensions are called as the tracheoles. And these tracheoles, they are divided off intima and tinnidia. Means intima and tinnidia, which we have seen in the structure in the trachea, they are absent in these tracheoles. Okay, these tracheoles, they are formed of a protein called as tracheine. Okay, and these tracheoles, they are filled with a fluid called as tracheolar fluid. Here you can observe the tracheolar fluid, tracheal fluid, which is also called as tracheal fluid. And the level of this tracheal fluid, it depends upon the metabolic activity of the cockroach. If the cockroach is metabolically inactive, means that is during daytime, when it is inactive, these tracheoles, they are filled with tracheolar fluid. And when the cockroach is active, means during nighttime, the tracheolar fluid is completely reabsorbed into the surrounding tissues. And these tracheoles, they penetrate into the cell and intimately associated with the mitochondria and supply oxygen and also nutrients to the cells. Okay. Respiration includes inspiration and expiration. Inspiration means taking in air, expiration means sending out air. The muscles helpful in this respiration are dorsoventral muscles and ventral longitudinal muscles. And out of these, the dorsoventral muscles, they are the principal muscles helpful in respiration. Okay? Let us now discuss the inspiration. Inspiration is taking in of air. Okay, this includes the relaxation of dorsoventral muscles. The dorsoventral muscles, they are get relaxed, and the tergal plates are elevated. As the tergal plates are elevated, the volume of the body cavity is also increased. As the volume of the body cavity is increased, pressure inside the body cavity is decreased. And further, the ventral longitudinal muscles also, they get relaxed, and the telescoped segments, they come to their original function. The volume is further increased, thereby the pressure inside the body cavity is decreased. Thereby, the air is drawn in due to the relaxation of muscles. As the air is drawn by the relaxation of muscles, the inspiration in cockroach is a passive process. The inspiration process in humans is an active process, whereas the inspiration process in cockroaches is a passive process, as it is because of relaxation of the dorsoventral muscles and also the ventral longitudinal muscles. Okay, now, and during this inspiration, the thoracic spiracles, they are kept open, whereas the abdominal spiracles, they are kept closed. Coming to the expiration, it is because of the contraction of the muscles, and this expiration is nothing but sending out air. This is because of the contraction of dorsoventral muscles. The contraction of dorsoventral muscles, it leads to the depression of the tergal plates, and the body cavity is decreased, and it is further decreased by the contraction of ventral longitudinal muscles, and the pressure inside the body cavity is further increased, which forces the air to go out. This process is called as expiration. As expiration is because of the contraction of dorsoventral muscles and ventral longitudinal muscles, the expiration process in cockroaches is an active process. Okay, na? And during this expiration, the thoracic spiracles, they are closed, whereas the abdominal spiracles, 8 pairs of abdominal spiracles, they become open. These insects like cockroaches, grasshoppers, bugs, etc., they exhibit discontinuous ventilation. Why we call it as discontinuous ventilation? Because during inspiration, the thoracic spiracles, they are opened, and the abdominal spiracles, they are closed. During expiration, these thoracic spiracles, they become closed, and whereas the abdominal spiracles, they become opened. This way, discontinuous ventilation is observed. Okay, the exchange of gases, it depends upon the metabolic rate and the temperature. And from the tracheoles, the O2 diffuses faster into the tissues. I have already told you, oxygen is diffused into the tissues and carbon dioxide is diffused into the hemolymph. And this oxygen diffuses faster into the tissues because of high partial pressure of oxygen. Whereas the carbon dioxide, it is carried more quickly into the hemolymph than into the tracheal system due to its greater solubility. Okay? And some CO2 is released out in the form of bursts. Okay, this finishes the respiratory system of cockroach. Let us recap our topic with few questions. Okay, the first question is, oropharyngeal tracheal system means all the spiracles in respiration are participated. Okay, and having 10 pairs of spiracles, only the thoracic spiracles are functional and only 2 spiracles are functional. What's your option? Very nice. The participation of all spiracles in respiration. Because of the participation of all spiracles in respiration, the respiration in cockroaches is called as holoneustic. Coming to the second question, the principal muscles for respiration in cockroach are lateral muscles, ventral muscles, ventrolateral muscles, and the dorsoventral muscles. What are the principal muscles for respiration in cockroach? What is your option? Very good. Dorsoventral muscles is the right option. And coming to the last question, in cockroach, the exchange of gases depends on, okay, the metabolic rate, the temperature, the flow of blood, and both metabolic rate and the temperature. What is your option? Yes, that's the right answer. Both metabolic rate and temperature. The option D, 1 and 2 is the right option. Okay, thank you. And you may follow my lessons for NEET and NSET simply by typing Lakshmi Narayana Gunta in YouTube. Thank you very much for watching.